Meb Keflezighi across the finish line one last time and collapsing.
Former San Diego caver Meb Keflezighi is back in San Diego following his 11th place finish in New York City. It was his 26th and final marathon of his illustrious career. Monday evening, Meb's hometown throwing a party at Liberty Station to celebrate his retirement. Matt Gilson was on the scene.
In the final marathon of his career, Meb Keflezighi had enough for 26.2 miles and not a step more.
Well, I was definitely spent at the marathon. I have no idea. I was just collapsed, depleted, obviously, and it was tough recovery for that day. I've been in San Diego kind of jogging a little bit here and there.
Of course, when Meb says he's been jogging, he means he's already logged more than 50 miles back home.
I don't have to run 120, 130 miles a week anymore, but if I can squeeze in 30, 45 to 50 miles a week, I think I'll be happier.
One of the many guests in attendance at Monday's retirement party, Mayor Kevin Faulkner.
On behalf of the people who hereby proclaim today, Meb Keflezighi in the city of San Diego.
It's great to have Mayor Faulkner here and celebrate the Meb Keflezighi Day, I guess. It's really an honor.
Meb is the consummate athlete, human being, professional, and a role model to us all. Meb is in and of San Diego, he's in and of the United States, and he's in and of the world.
In a video that played during the festivities, people from around the world shared their messages for Meb.
Meb. What's up, my brother?
Congratulations, Meb, on all you've achieved.
You gotta win more than one championship here in Boston, man. You gotta come back.
Meb is who I wanna be when I grow up.
If you could go back in time and talk to 12-year-old Meb when you arrived in San Diego, what would you tell him about this journey that you've been on since then?
Commitment, perseverance, and hard work. I was reading something that I wrote a long time ago, and that's what it comes to about marathon, that's what it comes about academics, and that's what it comes about life. And, you know, with the Meb Foundation, I love to give back more to young kids and help them visualize what their goal is, but failure is part of the process.
From Liberty Station, Matt Gilson, KUSI Sports.
Thank you, Matthew. In 29 days, a virtual who's who of the San Diego sports community will gather inside the hangar bay of the Midway Museum. The occasion, well, everybody knows. The 19th annual Silver Pigskin Gala. The purpose, well, everybody knows. To unveil the recipient of high school sports' highest honor, the prestigious Silver Pigskin. The 2017 e-ballot is officially ready to be transmitted. This week, every high school football coach will get a ballot. Every prep media entity will get a ballot. Every previous Silver Pigskin finalist will get a ballot. Every active member of the Prep Picks Report team will get a ballot. And a wide-ranging assortment of high-profile members of the greater football community will get a ballot. Last year, we sent out 287 such e-ballots. This year, we expect the number to be less, because if you didn't vote last year, you don't get a ballot this year. The number of return ballots is important because that number determines how the fan vote will get weighted. The fan vote is weighted to count as 10% of the returned ballot vote. It's very possible, in fact, likely, that the winner of the fan vote isn't the winner of the trophy. The Silver Pigskin, after all, is not a popularity contest. You, the viewers, can decide a close race, but it's the e-ballot voters that do all the heavy lifting as it relates to the crowning of San Diego number one high school football player. We also have some playoff games, 22 in fact. I want to call your attention to the El Cajon Ford East County Game of the Week. We are going to be live at Southwest El Centro. In fact, Matt Gilson is going to be live at two different games in the desert. We're going to be live at, or we're going to have highlights from all three games played in the desert as we continue to show you why we are the gold standard in high school football coverage. Make sure you tune in Friday night, 10:30, right here on the birthplace of the Prep Pigskin Report. With that said, we turn our attention to non-football sports. Playoff field hockey taking place. It's Mission Hills taking on University City. This is Monique Ornelas hitting down the field to Alyssa Rojas for the first of two goals. In the second half, Monique works the ball through the Centurion defense for a goal of her own. Mission Hills wins it 3-0. They will move on to get the winner of this one. Undefeated East Lake hosting Point Loma. First half, the Lady Titans. Noel Ertzner finds teammate Taylor Troop, who scores her second of the evening. Then moments later, it's Ertzner who intercepts the pass and takes a shot all by her lonesome as she finds the back of the net to extend the East Lake lead to 4-0. The Titans now 20-0 on the year. They win 5-0. They will host Mission Hills in the semis. San Diego Academy traveling to San Marcos. First half, the Knights have the 4-6-18 shot all wrapped up as Rachel Jackson hits the ball to Alyssa for Cucci, who sets up Natalie Blumfeld for the game's only score. 1-0 San Marcos. They get the winner of this one, a D2 quarterfinal. Westview hosting San Diego Southwest in the first half of the Wolverines. Lawley Stapley in the makes it 2-0 with a goal off the corner shot. Second half, Westview sophomore Sarah Stone with one of her game-high 4 goals. Wolverines win in a runaway, the final 7-1. The Wolverines will face San Marcos in the semis. Brian Dutcher received 3 signatures Monday. The Twin Towers named Mensa, both making their commitments to the Mesa official. Nathan and Joel Mensa, both standing 6'10" tall. 3-star guard Joel Campbell also signing on the dotted line Monday. And kudos to USD quarterback Anthony Lawrence, the former Silver Pigskin finalist, picking up another PFL Offensive Player of the Week award. Why not? He had his first 400-yard passing game as the Toreros run up the score against Davidson 63-7. In the process, they clinched their league title, and it's Anthony's third such honor.